Autofahren in Deutschland. Deutschland ist der Geburtsort des Automobils und seines Erfinders, Carl Benz. Nach wie vor gehört Deutschland zu den weltweit führenden Automobilherstellern und andere mit den Luxusautomarken wie Mercedes-Benz, BMW und Porsche. Das Autobahnnetz ist weltweit für seine Strecken ohne Geschwindigkeitsbegrenzung bekannt. Dies macht neben der hohen Dichte und dem allgemein guten Zustand der Straßeninfrastruktur das Fahren in Deutschland zu einem vergnüglichen, wenn auch etwas teuren Unterfangen. Innerhalb von Städten ändert sich jedoch das Bild, es ist meist stressig, in einer Stadt mit 500.000 Einwohnern oder mehr zu fahren. Viele Stadtzentren und Altstädte sind zudem verkehrsberuhigt. Hintergrund: Die Deutschen haben eine Leidenschaft für Autos. Das gilt auch für diejenigen, die selbst kein Auto besitzen, oder auch diejenigen, die sich gegen die oft autozentrierte deutsche Verkehrspolitik aussprechen. Eine Reihe von Comedians und Ärzten haben schon beobachtet, dass ein durchschnittlicher deutscher Mann sein Auto besser pflegt als seine eigene körperliche Gesundheit. Während viele Deutsche ihr Auto größtenteils eher als nützliches Objekt sehen, gibt es eine Minderheit, die es gar als Objekt der Leidenschaft, des Vergnügens und sogar der Liebe sieht. Und sie sind gut organisiert. Der ADAC ist die zweitgrößte Autolobbygruppe der Welt, hinter seinem US-amerikanischen Pendant, der American Automobile Association. Deutsche neigen auch zu Vorurteilen, zum Beispiel, dass Ausländer, insbesondere aus südlichen oder östlichen Ländern, eher unangepasst fahren und deshalb eher zurückhaltend in Deutschland fahren, insbesondere, wenn es deren erster Tag im Land ist. Nur weil es Strecken auf der Autobahn gibt, auf denen man 200 km pro Stunde fahren kann, heißt das nicht, dass man es muss. So ist zum Beispiel die Höchstgeschwindigkeit für LKWs, die meist nur auf der rechten Fahrspur fahren, auf 80 km pro Stunde beschränkt. Während insbesondere in den 1950er und 1960er Jahren viele Städte versuchten, möglichst autofreundlich zu werden, gewinnen nun immer mehr lokale Oppositionsgruppen und der Erhalt des architektonischen Erbes, anders als zum Beispiel in den USA, die Oberhand gegen die Autolobby. Die autofreundlichen Entwicklungen in einigen Städten werden immer mehr als Fehler der Vergangenheit angesehen, für die man sich schämen müsste, und sie werden rückgängig gemacht. Straßenbahnen sind in vielen Städten ein häufiger Anblick, und obwohl sie zunehmend nicht mehr auf der Straße fahren, sollte man sie in Städten wie Dresden im Blick haben, da sie bei einer Kollision unweigerlich gewinnen werden. An Sonn- und Feiertagen dürfen Lastkraftwagen mit einem Gesamtgewicht von mehr als 7,5 Tonnen oder Lastkraftwagen mit Anhängern ungeachtet des Gewichts nicht zwischen Mitternacht und 22 Uhr fahren. Es gibt jedoch zahlreiche Ausnahmen von dieser Regel, so zum Beispiel für LKWs, die verderbliche Produkte befördern. In der Praxis sind also auch sonntags viele LKWs auf den Straßen unterwegs. Autovermietung und Fahrgemeinschaften. All German Airports offer car rental services and most of the main rental firms operate at disc locations. Sometimes you can save a lot of money by going downtown, which is usually and cheap as hopping on a train that'll cost some coins, and renting a car there instead of paying various airport fees. Rental cars and pool cars are also available in most cities, and one-way rentals, within Germany, are generally permitted with the larger chains without an additional fee. When renting a car, be aware that most cars in Germany have manual gearbox, stick shift, so you might want to ask for a car with an automatic gearbox if you are used to that type. Drivers with an endorsement in their license that restricts them to driving automatic transmission vehicles will not be allowed to rent a manual transmission car. Automatic transmission cars have a, mostly undeserved, bad reputation in Germany and the locals usually avoid them. If you rent an electric car, the whole issue becomes a moot point. Most car rentals prohibit having their cars taken to Eastern European countries, including Poland and the Czech Republic. If you plan to visit these countries as well, you might choose to rent your car there, as those limitations do not apply the other way round. Another great way to get around without your own car is using one of the popular carpool services. You can arrange many connections over their respective websites if you speak some German or have a friend that can help you out. Making contact is free of charge and getting a lift is often the cheapest way to get around. Two of the most popular hosts are Fahrgemeinschaft and Besser mitfahren. If you have your own car, taking other people is also a great way of saving money and protecting the environment. Another very good site is found here which compares different means of transportation. BlaBlaCar is also a popular option. Verkehrsregeln: All foreign licenses are accepted for up to 6 months, or 12 months for a temporary stay only, but a translation may be necessary. If you want to continue driving after this period, you must obtain a German license. These rules do not apply to driving licenses issued in EU member states. To get a non-EU driving license approved for long-term use in Germany can mean anything from a short trip to a government office to taking an entire new driving class which may well set you back several hundred euro. This varies drastically by country of origin of your license and even by individual US state. Traffic offenses are almost always fined and severe offenses will lead to points being registered for your license. Too many points, 8, will lead to your driving license being confiscated. As this system cannot be applied to foreign licenses, fines for severe offenses are often significantly higher for foreign drivers to make up for the lack of long-term control. Some severe infractions carry a driving ban, usually a couple of months, in addition to a fine and points. As the central registry that keeps track of the points is located in Flensburg, bpcdhf.de in Flensburg. Traffic lights. Traffic lights are split for different directions, especially on large intersections, for one or more directions, an additional set of lights in the form of arrows regulates traffic in that direction. The non-arrow red light is for all other directions and traffic going straight ahead. Turning right on red is not permitted except when a small green right arrow is affixed to the traffic light, right next to the red light. Then, you may turn right carefully, but you must still stop and make sure that there is no traffic or pedestrians approaching. In many areas traffic lights are not hung over the intersection but placed at the corners. Do not creep into the intersection or you will not be able to see the lights change. A thick white stripe at intersections with traffic lights indicates where to stop. Many intersections use self-regulating traffic lights. The inductive sensor device used to determine if there's a car waiting is often located in the road surface in front of the white stripe mentioned above. Be sure to stop right in front of the white stripe or the sensor might not recognize you. Lights will still turn green but you will have to wait quite a while longer. Yellow lights are short in duration, 2-3 Sekunden, and are also used prior to the light turning green. The sequence is green, amber, red, red and amber, same as in the UK. If the yellow light is flashing, this means the traffic light either is defective or switched off, for example late at night or during weekends, and you then have to observe traffic signs or, if absent, the right before left rule. Driving through lights at red carries a fine, up to 200 euro. And will not be anticipated by any other road users. Keep in mind that pedestrians, especially. Verkehrsunfälle: If you are involved in an accident, immediately stop where it happened, except if you're on a autobahn or some other multilane road. Carefully get out of the car and check for injured people and damage on the cars. If there is only minor damage, immediately move your vehicle to the roadside so that you don't block the road. It is a good idea to take some pictures of the scene before moving the cars. Germans are really crazy about their cars and accidents. That's mainly because they're shocked and think preserving the scene for the police might help in some way. It's not unusual that they will block an entire 4-lane crossroad during rush hours just because you slightly touch their bumper. Don't bother. Check the situation and tell them they have to clear the road. Refer to the traffic regulations, Straßenverkehrsordnung, Paragraph 34.2, and maybe remind them of the fine for blocking the traffic. If there is only minor material damage, you are only obligated to exchange names, addresses and insurance information. It is always a good idea to write down a report, stating all involved cars, drivers, witnesses and how the accident happened. Have it signed by all parties. It is neither necessary nor mandatory to call the police. Some people will want to call the police and expect you to wait for them but you do not have to. If you are driving a rental car, the car rental may want you to call the police and file a report. Use this when picking up the car. In case of heavy damage or injuries, or one of the passengers complaining about headache, then it gets difficult. Injuries from car accidents often cause trauma with huge costs for medical treatment and the insurances will look very closely how the accident happened, and who is to blame. In this case do not move anything, secure the crash site and try to help injured people. Then call 112 for rescue service and state, where, what, how many casualties, which injuries, then wait for further instructions. Even if nobody is hurt but there is a lot of damage, with parts lying around, especially oil leaking, call 110 for police. They will come, regulate the traffic and will call someone to clean up the road. Most of the accidents, something around 80-90%, happen in cities and on rural roads. In the rare case you have an emergency on a autobahn, or some other multi-lane road with heavy or fast traffic, slow down without endangering the traffic around and stop on the emergency lane. First of all, before getting out of the car, watch out for the traffic. Each year people who are trying to help in an accident are fatally hit by another car. Put on your reflective vest, all passengers, get out on the right side of the car, the side without traffic, and get behind the guardrail. Take the breakdown triangle, usually out of the trunk, and place it approximately 150-200 meter, 500-650 Fuß, behind the car on the roadside. Always walk behind the guardrail. With the police involved there is also usually a fine to pay, Höchstgeschwindigkeiten speed limits are the following in Germany, unless otherwise shown. Walking speed, 4-7 km pro Stunde, on verkehrsberuhigter Bereich, traffic calmed area, marked by a blue white sign showing a pedestrian and a playing kid on the road. There are no lanes or sidewalks, cars don't have priority, parking is banned except in marked spots. 30 km pro Stunde in most residential areas within cities, marked with a sign 30 Zone Wohngebiet, 20 Zone and 10 Zone also exist, very often in combination within a right before left crossroad area. 50 km pro Stunde inside towns and cities. Be aware that there are no 50 speed limit signs on entry to a town or village, the yellow town sign is the marker for the start of the 50 km pro Stunde limit. And yes, that's why those signs are not at the same place as the administrative boundary. 100 km pro Stunde outside towns and cities, including Kraftfahrstraßen, marked by a sign showing a white car on a blue background. There is no constant general speed limit on the Autobahn or on Kraftfahrstraßen if there is any kind of barrier between two or more lanes of different direction. However, it is not an entirely unrestricted road whereas there are sections that are periodically or permanently assigned lower rates of speed. The recommended maximum speed Richtgeschwindigkeit on the Autobahn is 130 km pro Stunde, and if you drive on the Autobahn for your first time and are not yet used to the usual heavy traffic, you should not exceed that speed. In addition, if you are traveling in excess of 130 km pro Stunde and are involved in an accident, you can still be held liable for part or all of the damage regardless of fault on your part. On some rental vehicles, you might lose your insurance. The best way to think about going past 130 km pro Stunde is as a speeding violation, which isn't fined. In case someone makes a mistake, you are fully responsible, as if you broke the speed limit. When towing a trailer or operating a truck bus heavy vehicle, the maximum speed is 80 km pro Stunde, even on a road with a higher posted speed limit, unless the components are rated for a higher speed. The maximum speed for trucks on country roads is 60 km pro Stunde, not raised by speed signage either. Speed cameras are common in Germany, the country has one of the highest speed camera concentrations in Europe, and are found mostly in towns and cities. Temporary roadworks on the motorway are usually a favorite for the police to obey the speed limit, which is clearly marked. There is also some tendency to the shenanigans with the ortsschild, the yellow sign at the entrance of towns, which signifies the blanket 50 and Route X202 km/h speed limit in effect inside build-up areas, which is often further out on the edge of the settlement and sometimes moved without any change in the build environment. Sometimes there are official signs, Achtung Radar, or something similar, to warn about the speed camera. Take the advice, there can be a speed camera. All forms of radar jammers and fahren auf der Autobahn in 1974 Düsseldorf Electronic Music Pioneers Kraftwerk Hit A Hit with Autobahn, Witchbrot bot dem End der Roots the song Was About to the Attention of the World. For many listeners the line fahren auf der Autobahn might as well have been referring to fun on the Autobahn, since they took the song as an invitation to come to Germany and drive the Autobahn into the idyllic landscape of the album cover. The near total freedom from speed limits was a big part of the attraction, as well. It still is. Design standards call for generally level surfaces and wide, gentle turns, allowing higher speeds, and maintenance is intensive and regular. On nice weekends you'll find a lot of locals and foreigners out on the Autobahn in their Porsches or BMWs, or other high-performance vehicles, driving them the way they were designed to be driven. If you want to join in, if this is one of things you came to Germany to do, keep the following in mind. German drivers tend to drive faster, more aggressively and competitively than you might be used to, especially on the parts of the highway system without a speed limit. While most passenger vehicles have only a recommended speed limit of 130 km pro Stunde, buses have a speed limit of 100 km pro Stunde, or even 80 km pro Stunde, and most vehicles towing a trailer, along with buses in general and non-passenger vehicles with a gross weight of greater than 3,5 tonnen, are limited only to 80 km pro Stunde. Some newer trailers have a speed limit of 100 km pro Stunde. Road signs on the Autobahn show possible destinations, mostly city names. They do not show the direction of the road, east-west, unlike in some other countries. However, every odd-numbered Autobahn will go north-south, e.g. A49, whereas the even-numbered ones go west-east. Furthermore, single-digit Autobahn numbers indicate a very long Autobahn such as the A7 which goes from the border with Denmark all the way down to the Austrian border. Double-digit Autobahns are considerably shorter like the A73 that links Suhl in Thüringen with Nuremberg and triple-digit Autobahns are often urban highways and generally only of local importance such as the A100 which makes a never completed circle through Berlin. You must use the right lane free, even if everybody seems to prefer the left and middle lanes, where they exist. You may stay in the middle lane only if there are occasional slower vehicles on the right. Overtaking on the right is not allowed and will be dangerous since other drivers won't expect it. You must always pass vehicles on the left side, except in very slow-moving traffic queues. Before overtaking, look carefully behind as there might be really fast cars or bikes coming. You must indicate your desire to switch lanes by using your indicators before you switch. Autobahns have an emergency lane where you can stop only in case of a breakdown or other emergency. It's illegal and dangerous to stop there for any other reason. The E.